Are there any more questions from the audience?
Yeah, I have a question. Are we on candid camera?
Excuse me?
I mean, is this a joke? 300 million people in America, and this is our only hope? The people who won our vote?
Okay, someone take his microphone.
No, I'm gonna say this. Get off me. Someone needs to address the elephant in the room and the donkey. So excuse my definite lack of political correctedness and etiquette, but there's a reason more people vote for the American Idol than the American president. Rest in peace, Robin Williams, you were right. You said, look at the word politics. Polia, Latin word meaning many. Ticks meaning blood-sucking creatures. He was being facetious, but that is no falsehood. Why is it always the lesser of two evils? Never the greater of two goods. For too long, it has been normal for politicians to make empty promises and proclamations. Normal for them to dismiss the Constitution and Declaration. Normal for them to think more about the next election than the next generation. Well, it is 2020, by golly. Ain't it time for a new normal?
Ha, the new normal. I'm tired of people like you criticizing us. Tell us about this new normal. Why don't you come up here and tell us how you would do it if you were the president?
Me?
Duh. Watch this, Sleepy Joe.
Shut up, man.
Well, first thing I would do if I was president is quit.
See, I knew he was a coward.
Let me finish. See, the word president literally means preside over or sit before. I would quit my position of being everybody's superior. I would sit together with the people as equals. Next, I would take Congress back to kindergarten.
See, I knew he was slow.
Wait, what do you mean?
Well, see, everything government needs to know they should have learned in kindergarten. Think about it. Our climate policy should be based on the kindergarten philosophy of clean up your own mess and put things back how you found them. Our foreign policy should be don't hit people. Economic strategy, yeah, play fair, and if you hurt someone, make it better. In our domestic policy, hold hands and stick together. Even though we'd have kindergarten policies, if I was president, I would use a lot of adult language. Some people may be offended, but I wouldn't budge. I would use strong four-letter words like love, like hope, like care, like free, like hero. Yes, I would awaken the hero and shiro in all of us, because change rarely comes from Washington. The stimulus checks will always bounce in the long run and come back insufficient funds, because you cannot stimulate a country until you stimulate the hearts.
It's easy to speak rainbows and sunshine. Where would you stand specifically on key issues?
You know, I'm glad you brought that up. See, if I was president, my key issues wouldn't be getting rid of TikTok. My key issues would unlock the doors of freedom that have been blocked for so many. So we, as a country, would focus on eliminating child trafficking, the equality of all genders, the genocide of helpless animals. We must be defenders, because a nation's greatness is measured not by how it treats the wealthy, but how it treats its weakest members. So many rich folks in government is sad. See, they've been worried more about securing the bag than securing us from a crash.
How dare you?
Sir, don't get mad. Everyone should be able to prosper, not just the prosperous. So if I was president, I would get with the people and decide how our budgets should be spent in a way that's fair, transparent, and makes sense. Maybe instead of war, we'd help unemployed people struggling to pay rent. That would increase our nation's strength. If I was president and in the Oval Office, we would stop mopping up the floor and finally turn off the faucet.
What do you mean?
Well, instead of getting to the root causes, we keep trying to fix the symptoms. For instance, we spend billions on cures, but practically nothing on prevention. You guys talk about healthcare, but refuse to mention the broken food system. Dudes, listen, COVID wouldn't have killed so easily and with such frequency had we not had the pre-existing epidemic of obesity. What's the reasoning 21 ingredients are in this McDonald's fry? Don't you see how fast food has given us short lives? Guys, do you even care? Or maybe you're not aware that children born in the year 2000 will be the first generation with a shorter lifespan than their parents. We should be embarrassed. If I was president, universal wellness will be at the top of our list. Doctors will be paid to keep you healthy, not just treat you when you're sick. And as far as mental health, we would work fast to pass a bill. Cause this next fact is sad but real. Did you know more soldiers die from suicide when they come home compared to those killed on the battlefield? It is so much we have to rebuild. As far as women go, they should be free to make their own choices for their own bodies. Men should never regulate it. Students would have the final say in exactly how they are educated. Basically, what I'm saying is, to solve problems, everyone's voice should be heard. There are so many folks with brilliant ideas that would finally get the attention they deserve. Because the strongest nation in the world will never be the U.S., will never be Russia or anywhere in Asia. The strongest nation is imagination. Imagine if government and people actually collaborated. We would solve real problems and make transformations. We would shine like the stars in the sun. We would use music to heal the world like guitars over guns.
How about race relations? Where would you stand on that issue?
Well, as far as race relations, we gotta be brave. So if I was president, I would make travel in the country mandatory, all expenses paid. Because when you see people who look different from you up close, you soon realize we are all the same. Also, I would tell my white brothers and sisters to wake up and heal the past injustices carried out by their ancestors.
That's it, Nani.
And the current ones. I would tell my black brothers and sisters what Dr. King said, that black supremacy is just as dangerous as white supremacy. It's not about white power or black power or any love of power. It's about the power of love. And you can't spell evolve without it.
And how about poverty? How would you solve that one?
Well, when it comes to poverty, that's easy. $200 billion worth of food thrown away each year. Instead of trash cans, put it into the empty stomachs of the needy. Stop being greedy. Everyone has a right to be fed. In the U.S., there are 5 empty homes for each person without one. Everyone has a right to a roof over their head.
He's talking about communism.
No, sir. I ain't talking about communism or socialism. I'm talking about humanism. My inspiration is not Karl Marx, it is the human heart. Plus, don't you call yourselves Christian? Well, at the end of your life, you will stand in front of God. He won't care if you won some high office. Believe me, he will say, yeah, congratulations. But when I was hungry, you didn't feed me. When I was naked, you didn't clothe me. I had no house and you gave me no shelter. Guys, have we forgotten about our sisters and brothers? I mean, the meaning of life is to take care of each other. Yo, which camera is on me? This one? Look, America, my ancestors came to this country on slave ships. Maybe yours came on immigrant ships. Whatever the original ship, we're in the same boat now, and it's sinking. It is a dark time for us all. It's hard, but it is only in the darkness that we see the stars. We must not turn on each other, but to each other. Give up our pride. Left wing, right wing, a bird with only one wing can't fly. Or flies in circles. Forget the labels. We've tried everything, from politics to riots, rallies, marches, protests, and they've all played a role. But now, today, we need something bold. We need each and every soul to wake up, to look deep in your core. What problem does your heart want to solve? Do not ignore. Because when we all answer the call, we open a new door that elevates humanity and creates a new normal that we have never seen before. I wish there were mirrors in every voting booth, because the truth is, we have always been and always will be the ones we are waiting for.
Right there.
Guys, listen, don't click off yet. I want to say this. It's not about America. It's not about any country. Countries are artificial lines drawn on a man-made map. There's one world, and it is up to us to come together and bring this world to where it needs to be.
I know it can seem hopeless at times, but it isn't. Speak up, use your voice, vote.
And despite what you may see on TV, there are people doing good. I worked on this project with an organization called the Elevate Prize Foundation. They award $5 million each year to individuals and organizations that are working hard to solve problems to change this world. Not only do they give them funding, but they give them access to mentors and coaches and help them build a huge following. This year, they have selected 10 winners. They are amazing people, amazing heroes, and I want you to check them out. You can make a difference by supporting their work, following their journey, and sharing what they are doing in this world. The time is now to come together. The time is now to awaken the hero in all of us. I want you to go to elevateprize.org and learn more. Peace.